Hi, I'm Dr. Stan Kuchar, and I'm going to speak with you about a really interesting and somewhat confusing topic. When is depression not depression? Now, I know that sounds a bit strange, because depression, that's depression. Well, not really. You see, it has become very popular in our society, throughout our media, to label every negative emotional feeling as depression. Now, that causes confusion, because there is a mental illness called depression. And when we confuse regular, expected negative emotions with a mental illness, we have a big problem. It's called medicalizing normal life. We don't want to do that. It's like taking an antibiotic every time that you cough. You'd be silly to do that, wouldn't you? Well, if we think that negative emotions, like, and we call them depression, are the same thing as the mental illness, depression, then why not take a pill for it? Why not take some psychotherapy for it? Why not just every time we feel depressed, we get some treatment? That just doesn't make any sense either. It's like taking an antibiotic for a cough. So how can we differentiate? First of all, is that we have to understand that every single person gets many, many, many negative feelings every day, every week, every month, every year. It's normal. It's your brain telling you that something in your environment is not exactly right, may not be good for you, and that you've got to do some changing. You've got to change your environment, you've got to change yourself, or you've got to change both. And those negative feelings drive change. And when you change your environment, say you're having fights and fights and fights with the same person all the time, you get a new friend. Well, the fights go away, you're not down anymore, you're not having depression anymore. Well, you never had depression in the first place. You were just having negative emotions. So we also have to start using the right words. If I'm feeling unhappy, say unhappy. If I'm disgruntled, say disgruntled. If I'm disappointed, I'm disappointed. If I'm distressed, I'm distressed. If I'm demoralized, I'm demoralized. If I'm disaffected, I'm disaffected. If I'm angry, I'm angry. If I'm irritable, I'm irritable. If I feel withdrawn, I feel withdrawn. If I feel sad and lonely, I feel sad and lonely, not depressed. So we really need to start thinking critically about how we use our language. You know, the English language and every other language is full of words that describes a plethora of different emotional states, different negative emotional states, and there are nuances in those meanings. There are really specific meanings. The word disgusted and the word demoralized are both negative emotional states, but they don't mean the same thing. The word disengaged and the word disappointed are both negative emotional states, but they don't mean the same thing, and none of those words mean depressed. So let's think more critically about what are the emotions that we're feeling? What are the words that we can use to label those emotions? How do those different emotional states differ one from the other? They're all negative emotional states, but they're all very different. And then how can we use that understanding and knowledge to better identify our emotions, to better understand what we can do with them, and to differentiate them from the mental illness called depression? Because having a depression is a medical disorder, and we need to treat depression, and we are pretty good at treating it. But having a negative emotional state, that's not a mental illness. That's called life. Thanks, Dr. Stan Kuchar.